Gatling FrontLine, Gatling's enterprise version, is a load testing tool for web applications. It includes many advanced features, intent of execution, reporting, and integration. Gatling FrontLine is a backend for Gatling. It is available on premises. You configure all the steps of your load testing campaign through a web interface or through our public REST APIs. You can connect with your user ID and your password, and you access a dashboard with all the simulation that you've configured. A team is dedicated to each simulation. On the right side of your dashboard, you can see some information about the latest run made for each simulation. You can connect in the morning and see how all your tests went during the night. There are two parts for the reporting. First of all, you can access a live reporting dashboard for each run with different kinds of metrics. Then you will be able to access a history of all the runs made for each simulation. In the live reporting dashboard, you can find different tabs with different kinds of metrics. The first one is the request tab. This is where you can find the number of requests and responses per second, the responses per second by status, the response times distribution, and the number of errors per second. You can filter by scenarios, groups, and types of requests. You can also switch to an overall view of all your requests and filter a request by the world's 95th percentile. The second tab is a tab dedicated to groups. You can design groups in your Gatling simulation in order to have a functional view in your report. For instance, for the login process. The third tab is your injection profile. This is where you can check your user's arrival rate, termination rate, meaning when your users are leaving the system, and the number of concurrent users in your system. You also have metrics about TCP connections. A typical bottleneck could be your system that is unable to close enough TCP connections per second, and this is where you can track this. You can also check the TCP connect durations, and if you are using HTTPS, the TLS handshake durations. The next tab is about bandwidth usage. This is where you can see if you are not saturating your network during the test. Finally, you can find in each report a tab dedicated to the monitoring of your load injectors. This is where you can check if the behavior of your load injectors is normal or not and doesn't impact all your metrics. On each tab, you can put markers that help you analyze your report. To share your reports, there are two ways. You can either create public links to let users access a specific dashboard without any credentials. They won't be, however, able to navigate in Gatling's FrontLine interface. You can also generate a PDF report. You access an interface where you can design your own reports with all the charts available. You can even mix different runs if you need to compare one run with another one. To compare two runs, you can also access the history of all the runs made for a specific simulation. You can check the status of each run, you can write comments and titles, you can find trends below with the following KPIs, requests and responses, response time percentiles, and the throughput. This is how you can easily detect if you have any performance regression from one run to another. To go further, you can even compare one run with another one with a specific KPI, for instance, the 95th percentile. To configure your simulation, it is really straightforward. In order to configure your existing Gatling simulations, you give it a name and a team in Gatling FrontLine, and you write its Scala class name. Then you choose how your simulation must be fetched. It can be either on a local repository, on your Git repository, your Nexus repository, Artifactory repository, or even your AWS S3 bucket. You then choose how many load injectors you'd like to have for your tests. Pools are groups of pre-configured instances for your load injectors. We will see just after how to configure them. For instance, I can choose two AWS instances in Frankfurt, Germany, and three in Dublin, Ireland. By default, the load will be distributed evenly, but this is something you can customize by saying I want 40% of my traffic coming from Frankfurt and 60% coming from Dublin, and you can do geographical distribution. There are different kinds of instances for your load injectors. You can either deploy on-premises instances, meaning instances that you've already opened and configured, but we also support on-demand instances with most of the cloud providers of the market. Gatling FrontLine will use your own credentials to open instances, deploy load injectors, and close them automatically after the end of the test. We also support Kubernetes and OpenShift for the deployment of your load injectors. In terms of integration, we have plugins for your CI solution like Jenkins, Bamboo, and TeamCity. We also have a Grafana data source to design your own dashboards and mix, for instance, your Gatling FrontLine metrics with your monitoring metrics. If you'd like to go further in terms of integration, we have public APIs documented on Swagger.